Well, ever since you could walk, Katie Rockenberger was keen to follow in the footsteps of her mum, Maxine, and to be involved in harness racing. She certainly had an interesting journey since. I caught up with Katie following her commitment to Club and Angle tonight. Well, Katie, good to catch up with you. Gillaby Silvestre finished at the tail of the field in his assignment tonight, but he's a work in progress.
Yeah, he is. He's been away for a long time, so tonight was just to give him a run, and he's never seen an angle and never run sort of these times before, so yeah, just to give him a feel.
He's an outstanding type. He's had 47 starts now, 13 wins and 14 placings, and he's been up against some very strong company throughout his career, but he's obviously had plenty of issues.
Yeah, he's had pretty much issues his whole career, but Marg and the boys and that down there, they've always done a good job with their good horses, and they did well to keep him going for so long.
You gave him four solid trials, so he's building up, but no doubt he'll need another few races.
Yeah, he'll probably need a few runs and a better draw, but just pray for that.
How'd you get this particular fella off, Marg Lee?
Well, he was pretty much retired, and then I just got him as a riding horse. He was just my favourite horse when I was down there, and just absolutely love him. And I said to Jason, I said, I'm taking him with me when he's done, and I'll just ride him. And he was a riding horse for a fair while. I took him up the mountains and actually lost him up there for about 8 hours. Him and Bonsall Benjamin went for a bit of a run and got him back, and his legs looked fine after that. So I was like, oh, and then you can come back into work. When I took the job with Dance Picker after they bought Uribe studs, so they had a water walker there, so I was like, oh, may as well just try her and see how it goes.
You describe him as a cool character. Why?
Oh, nothing really worries him at all, except for the day he ran away, but he just could not give a care in the world about anything.
As a little girl, you got associated with a gentleman in harness racing, Peter Carson, his wife Kathy. I knew Peter going way back when, the late Peter Carson we're speaking of. The trotter these days, Cody, owe a lot to the fact that Peter Carson just kept batting and batting for them and would fill up fields just so they could go around at Harold Park.
Yeah, I remember when I was a kid, there was only ever one ever pacer in the stable at a time. The rest were trotters, and they could be working like a crazy amount, and they were just all trotters, and just fell in love with the trotter over the pacer. But he just kept pushing and pushing for the trotters, and yeah, he'd come travel all the way to even Menangle, fill up a gooseneck of trotters just to keep him going every week.
He'd be a very proud man now if he could see how the trotter has now eventuated into one of our star attractions.
Yeah, he'd be so happy to see how they're still fill up like the meeting on a Tuesday, and then and how fast they're going now and just how strong they are.
So how did you get involved with Peter Carson?
My mum was really good friends with Kathy, and we only lived about a couple of minutes up the road in Nowra, so used to go there pretty much every day before and after school. When holidays, I just would hide from mum if she'd come to pick me up, and just pretty much live there.
Your love for the trotter no doubt stemmed from Peter.
Yeah, definitely.
As a young girl, you graduated into the mini trotters, and you love that to the point where you represented New South Wales in New Zealand in the kids' carts, and that was a wonderful experience.
Yeah, it was great, and went with a few really good people from over here, and I was really good friends with Leonard Caney, went over, and our families get along really good, so we made a holiday of it too.
Yeah, so getting involved with the mini trotters was an important transition into the big horses.
Yeah, definitely. It definitely helps because like I grew up around here and knew a lot of trainers and that, but used to just get along with everyone, say hello.
You've had an interesting journey as far as your career is concerned. You started out in the early stages with Christian Cunningham and Daniel Roll.
Yeah, they're another like good friends. They lived in the next town over and used to go over to their place, and most of the time I didn't even go to school. I was just at Christian's place and we're mucking around with ponies and the racehorses and just selling a few, and it was a bit of fun.
As an 18-year-old, you had your first drive for Daniel Roll, and it was a winner at Canberra, Boobalaga Ray, which is a very talented performer for him.
Yeah, it was good. I was a bit nervous before that race because he was a free-legger, and they all thought he'd go pretty good, but no one really told me. But they all thought he'd just win. I was like,
Well, that was the first of the achievements, and they just kept on rolling. 2019, picked in the New South Wales Rising Stars.
Yeah, I had a good run there. Dennis and Grant were a big part of that. They just would fill up a truckload wherever we went, and yeah, they gave me great opportunities.
Also that year you drove one of your feature winners for the first time, the Junie Pacers Cup with Smooth Sailor.
Yeah, I loved that horse. He had a lot of tricks, but that win meant a lot to me and Dennis and the family.
2020, you decided to head to Victoria.
Yep, so I stayed in Queensland for a bit with Dennis Picker and that, and then I had a fall, and then once I come back from that, I went to Victoria to work for Marg Lee.
And that learning experience working with Marg, who is certainly an outstanding performer as a mentor, both with the Trotter and the Pacers.
Yeah, definitely. Learn a lot off Marg and everyone down there, especially like Patty and Jason and Glenn. They spend a lot of time with you too. Like, they don't miss much, and they tell you what you've done wrong and to fix it up.
I don't know how they keep up with all the Kuyangs. There's a meal.
There's a lot of Kuyangs and there's a lot of Jillabies, but somehow they remember them all.
Back in November of 2023, you combined with Steve Duffy, who you were doing some work with a horse called Serge Blanco, to win the Yarra Valley Pacing Cup, beating a very smart type in Captain Ravishing and Max Delight in third spot. What a thrill.
Yeah, it was a big thrill. He won a cup just a few days before that as well, but we were a bit unsure. We thought he'd go close, but Captain Ravishing is just a great horse. But just had the perfect trip, and yeah, that was a great win.
Yeah, you led out, took a sit, won by 9.5 metres, so it was a convincing display.
Yeah, just pulled him out at the top of the straight, and he's a very, very fast horse.
Each New Year's they hold a big meeting at Melton, and you were selected for the Young Guns, another big ticket in your favour.
Yeah, it was a really good night. Was really fortunate to get picked for that. Didn't have much luck, but it was a great experience.
You know, got your trainer's license, which you've had now for a few years, but you've worked, as we mentioned, with Marg Lee, Steve Duffy, Dennis Picker, Daniel Roll, Kristen Cunningham, but also Amy Day and Amanda Turnbull, and in particular James Rattray, who gave you a very big kick in your career.
Yeah, he trusted me with a lot of good horses, and it was great. We were working some really, really good horses at the time, and he gave me my first Menangle winner as well.
And that just happened to be a trotter. Can you remember the name?
Yep, Yo-Yo Landy. She was a little pocket rocket.
Okay, it's been great to catch up with. So how many horses do you have in work as far as your own training?
I think I have 5 there at the minute.
And you're working with Dennis Picker, as you mentioned?
Yep.
So we'll keep an eye on Jillaby Silvestro. No doubt the cool character will come to the fore very shortly. But great to catch up with you, Cody, and a lot of success in your career.
Yep, thank you.